What's up mga kuya, welcome back to the channel and welcome to PC Troubleshooting episode number 2. So here's the thing. My last episode of PC Troubleshooting was 3 years ago. Wow! And as I mentioned in that video that I will only do these types of videos if I experience the problems myself. Which I didn't want, of course. So today's problem is faulty RAM or memory, whichever term you want to use. Also, this is probably going to be a short video. Apparently, I have been experiencing this problem for quite a while now. I just didn't know it was a problem with my RAM itself. And I was able to diagnose and resolve this problem last November when I had the time. And this video is probably more for the people who are new or are not that familiar with PC troubleshooting. The specific memory kit that I have is the T-Force Delta RGB DDR4 3000MHz a 2x8GB kit. So here are like the symptoms that I was experiencing for quite a while. First off is the XMP profile turned on, setting the clock speed of my RAM to 3000MHz. The symptoms are my PC turning on for a second and turning off immediately, which sounds familiar, but this time it's actually a problem with my memory. If my PC did successfully boot, my games would randomly crash and the blue screen of death or BSOD. But with XMP disabled and my RAM running at 2400MHz, my computer works perfectly fine, but doesn't seem to use the other 8GB stick, which was apparent when I was using Adobe Premiere or After Effects, just maxes at 8GB of memory usage. So in my case, just one of my RAM sticks was faulty, and before you do any type of troubleshoot, if you own a desktop or laptop, then I highly advise you to have extra parts. So in the event that your computer fails, then you have extra parts. Yeah, so the first troubleshoot I did is to reset both RAM sticks, turned it on, and set the XMP profile. After saving the settings, my PC rebooted and turned up shortly after. So at first, I actually thought that it was a problem with my motherboard, like it's not able to handle higher RAM speeds. So yeah, troubleshoot your memory first before thinking that. But moving on, next I tried using just one of the memory sticks, set the XMP profile, and my computer booted without any problems. I tried playing some games and did a few benchmarks and didn't run into any problems. Next I tried using the other RAM stick by itself, set the XMP profile again, and yeah. My computer can't boot successfully with this one, and as I mentioned earlier, with both memory sticks plugged in, my RAM usage just maxes out at 8GB. And yeah, I think that was a pretty simple and easy troubleshoot. At least I think so. So my only real problem now is I need to send both my RAM sticks to get it remade. Yep, apparently you need to send both RAM sticks even though just one stick is faulty. I'm not sure if that's how it goes for other brands or just maybe RAM in general, but yeah. So before I sent my memory kit for RMA, I had to purchase a new kit or just stick. Thankfully, just using a single 8GB stick was enough for my use, for the most part. Which, going back to what I said earlier, it's important to have extra parts for your PC in the event that something fails. But yeah, that's gonna do it for episode 2 of PC Troubleshooting, and hopefully this video helps you guys out. Leave a like if you like my content, and consider subscribing and hit the bell icon so you don't miss out on my latest videos. As always, the good stuff, use my Shopee, Lazada, or Banggood affiliate link if you're buying anything from them, it helps me out a lot. Like my Facebook page for other posts and updates that I don't post on YouTube. Also, watch me on my Shopee Lives where I help people out and talk about pretty much anything. As always, stay safe mga kuya. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace!